Did you know you can tell how fast a steam locomotive will go just by looking at it? I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. No, seriously, you really can. Although the reason is not quite as obvious as you might think. I'm back in Durand, Michigan with the Grand Trunk Western 5632, and we're going to use this as an example just to see just how fast this can go. Based on some fairly simple formulas and some design features that we can see just by looking at this. But before we do that, let's actually take a good look at what our limitations really are, because there's a few limitations that we have to work with. Of course, one of the challenges of shooting around railroads, especially in a railroad town, Durand, Michigan is a big railroad town still, is that you do occasionally have unexpected delays. What kinds of limitations do we have when it comes to the maximum speed on a steam train or the maximum cruising speed on a steam train? Well, the first one is the most obvious. How much steam can you produce? Most of what you see on a steam locomotive is actually the boiler. Okay, that's actually the boiler's inside of that. There's a layer of insulation before the outer layer. But still, most of what you see there is boiler. If you can't make enough steam, you can't go any faster. Second thing we're looking at, actually right here. See all those big, huge connecting rods in there? Steam trains are heavy. Those things weigh 100, 200 pounds a piece. And you have to move those back and forth with every single revolution. The faster you go, the more force you're putting on them, the more likely you are that they'll just simply snap off. If they bend or snap, your train stops. Third one, actually right up here. You have the piston, but you also have the running gear assembly above it. That actually controls the steam in and out of the piston, on both sides of the piston. Steam trains run double acting pistons. The steam has to be able to get from the boiler down to here, expand into the piston, and move the piston. Steam can only do that at just a certain speed. And finally, you have this, your driver wheels. The driver wheels, the bigger they are, the faster your train can go. Essentially, the bigger they are, the farther you can go with each single revolution, and that means that each RPM you add will add that much more distance. So what actually matters? So between the boiler, the running gear, the pistons, the steam compression, the massive rods you're moving around, the massive wheels you're turning, the tendency of all those things to bend or break if you run them too fast, people who designed steam locomotives came up with a standard. And that standard, and it's a rough standard, the standard is that the cruising speed of a steam locomotive, maximum cruising speed, is going to be about 333 revolutions per minute. And the maximum theoretical speed of a steam locomotive is about 555 revolutions a minute. Now, where did they come up with these stupid numbers? And that's a really great question. And let me pull out some notes because there's a really good explanation for this. Okay, so this locomotive has 72-inch drivers on it. it has 73 inch drivers on it. So the circumference is 73 times pi. Circumference is 229 inches. So each revolution, the train will move 229 inches forward. Now at 333 RPM, that means that in a minute, it'll move 76,369 inches forward. Take that up to an hour, multiply it by 60, you have 458,139 inches. About now you're starting to think, why does any of this matter? Stick with me here a second. It gets good here in just a second. There's 63,360 inches in a mile. So if we do 458,139 divided by 63,360, you end up with 72.3 miles per hour. And remember, 73 inch drivers. So by designing for a 333 RPM maximum cruising speed on a steam locomotive, you can tell how fast that is, because basically it's the number of inches in your of your driver wheels. So by looking at a locomotive like this, the bigger the wheels, faster it'll go. So what about that 555? Well, think of that 333 RPM like the cruising speed in your car. So you have an idle speed, you have a cruising speed. At your cruising speed, you can do that all day long. You're not going to do any damage to your car, just some routine maintenance every, 5,000 miles or whatever. You can also floor it. You can redline your car, at which point you might not be driving your car much longer. And that's sort of the case with locomotives if they were pushed to 555 RPM. Quite a few places I looked at actually referred to it as a theoretical maximum and said that they weren't sure that any locomotives would actually be able to get there. And if they did, they probably wouldn't be able to stay there long. The reason simply being that they'd run out of steam. It's kind of a common phrase when you think about it, and a lot of the common everyday phrases, like, you know, I'm really tired, I'm out of steam. That happened with these things. For example, the one steam locomotive I've actually driven, the Flag Coal Company number 25, had a chance to run that a few years ago briefly. And I was talking to the owner of it, and I asked him how fast it could go. He said, well, it could get up about 40, 45 miles an hour, but we couldn't maintain that because the boiler will only get up to about 25. And so the boiler can maintain a speed of about 25 miles per hour. You can do surges faster than that, but you just can't maintain it. And much bigger boiler, the Flag Coal Company 75, just a little switch or tank engine compared to this one. We've got exactly the same problem. If you put too much steam into the pistons, you run out of steam and then you slow down. And that's actually a problem. You can run out of steam and halfway up the hill, have to actually back all the way down the hill, go back a couple miles, build up steam and take another run at it, managing your steam better. And that happens. And that's probably not the best way to maintain your status as an engineer if you do that very often. But anyway, that's how you can tell, just looking at the drivers on a steam locomotive, just how fast they can go. Take the diameter in inches, that's your speed in miles per hour. Couldn't be simpler. Anyway, I do need your help to keep this channel going. If you've enjoyed the video, please hit like and subscribe. Also, I do have a Patreon page over at patreon.com/industrialrevolution if you could help out there. This channel obviously involves a lot of travel to come out and see stuff like this. So if you could help me out, I'd appreciate that. Membership start is just a few bucks a month. So if you want to know how fast one of these things goes, it's simple. Just look at the drivers. The diameter in inches, that's its speed in miles per hour, and that's the Industrial Revolution.